clean my enclosure. Dad need to clean my enclosure.
Alrighty, guys. So as he starts to wake up, if you can just realize how big he's gotten. Jesus Christ. I think last time I weighed him, he was, actually, I have a note of it. Let's see what he was last time we weighed him. He's just waking up, so he might be a little slow to get going. Alright, and he was 540 grams. I haven't weighed him in a little bit. I weighed him the 3rd of, September, so it hasn't been too long, which I have switched him to bi-weekly, just because he was getting a little fat. We'll see what he does. He's probably going to decide to try and go off. No? Okay. But today's video, as he chokes me out, he's just holding on, I swear. But for today's video, we're going to react to ball python TikToks. He's actually squeezing a good amount. Cannot lie. That's what everybody thinks when you first get a snake. Think I'm going to die. Think I'm going to get wrapped up and killed. But no, he's a sweet thing. But yeah, we're going to go looking through TikToks. And, yeah, this is Bryson. If you've never met Bryson, this is my ball python. He's about a year and some change, maybe. Maybe not even a year. Maybe like 9-10 months. But yeah, he's gotten very big. And let's get on to the video. You stay on the table. All I gotta do, I just gotta get my AirPods. Just gotta get my AirPods. I know, you can come up, hang out with me. Just hold on, just let me get my AirPods in, bro.
Okay. He's not that big. Act like he's that big. This is my satchel.
But yeah, let's react to ball python TikToks. And I guess my headphones didn't even connect. Yeah, while I was getting that situation fixed, he decided to crawl on the mic. I wonder,
like, what y'all hear. If y'all can hear him, like, gazing at, or, not gazing at, grazing with an R.
You stupid!
That's the word. But yeah, let's react to TikToks. Very beautiful snake, but I mean, it's a filter too, guys. It's actually, let's do this filter with Bryson real quick. Good. I'll just throw it up in the corner. And if you want to go follow my TikTok, it's Parker's Pets and Pythons. Same as YouTube. Go follow me on there. I post some snake content, some of my personal content, just me hanging out with friends, stuff like that. But we'll go ahead and hashtag ball pythons. You know? And then we'll post it. Okay, next video.
Angry. Oh.
That's a lot of fucking eggs.
It is. Especially for a first time mama. Oh god.
Oh god, this is in my way.
Oh, she's happy. She's sitting on a clutch of eggs. And you know, that means she is a great time to get out.
You are.
She is mad.
So we actually have a ball python at my work that's kind of like this. It's a banana lemon blast. And it is a very fun snake to handle, if you want to call it that. It hates me.
And it pretty much tries to bite you whenever you get it out. A very tense ball python. We're trying to work with it, but, you know.
You're probably going to think I'm weird. Yeah.
Are you very docile and loving? Are you? Are you? Are you docile and loving? I think he is. Castaways. We are castaways. He doesn't take up too much space. I mean, for a smaller room. I mean, even then it's okay. I'm sorry. I just want to get you off of that. For like a decent sized room, I still have like all this room over here. So from what you see in the video and from like how much room, and there's a desk here and all that. So yeah, they don't take up too much room. Sorry, I know I'm kind of tapping you in the head. Ahoy there, ahoy, we are castaways. Yeah, they're very low maintenance. As long as you don't let them get tied up in a knot like that. This guy, I mean, I feed him twice a week now. Once a week when they're... Oh, my God, I'm kicking things. Once a week, usually when they're babies. And then you can jump them to twice a week once they start to get bigger. Okay. But, yeah, very low maintenance. I might clean up poop every week or other week. Just because they don't poop a lot. You change out their bedding about monthly, clean their stuff, clean off their glass, stuff like that. And, I mean, you mist them unless you have a PVC enclosure. Usually those hold humidity a lot better. But yeah, pretty low maintenance. And yes, number four, they are adorable. As you can see. Yeah, they live long. They can live like 20, 30 years. I think like usually around, I don't know. I don't think it's 40 years max. I gotta see what the record is. But yeah, these guys are long time commitments. Long term. It's a long term relationship right here. So yeah, that one's pretty good TikTok. We're not gonna watch that one because I don't know how YouTube will like it. I've posted feeding
don't
stuff.
Don't kill yourself while I put my hair back up.
Yeah, so ball pythons are not very sturdy. Or like, they're hardy, but they absolutely suck at hanging on to stuff. And they love to go. They love to move. They love to find dark places, but they also love to move. Like, especially if you get one like Bryson right here. He's very socialized. He likes to move around, stuff like that. So see, if I put him on the desk, guaranteed he's going places. Like, I'll watch him, but guaranteed, watch, he's gonna get himself tangled up in the wire. And like a lot of times, like if you sit your snake down, don't just go like scoop him up by the head. Yeah, like if you could see right now, he's going on an adventure. Sorry about that. So yeah, like, if you sit these guys down, they're going places. So you better watch them. If you let them climb, they're pretty bad climbers. I have a branch. I'll show you, but his branch in his enclosure, I'll hear him fall off of it at night. So he can't even hang on to, like, a branch that's, like, that straight of a lineup. So, yeah, they're not great at holding on to things.
Ball python unboxing.
Buddy,
a lot of these are just like clutch.
This is not how a snake do.
You leave that beautiful snake alone. If he wants to snake upside down, let him snake upside down. Besides, He was kind of literally bred to do it. I'll explain. Alright, that's better. So that was a bumblebee ball python, and bumblebee refers to the morph of the snake, just like you have different breeds of dogs that have been bred to have different traits. For years, breeders have bred different morphs of ball pythons, trying to make them more pretty, more desirable, and more valuable. Breeders started paying people to import snakes from the wild that might have new genes that weren't in the hobby yet, and eventually a snake was imported into the country around 1999 that had these really thin lines on it, kind of looked like a spider web going over the snake, and that was the very first spider ball python. But there was...
Yeah, so I'll sum up that video. Spider ball pythons are known to have a head wobble sometimes. So basically, instead of snaking like this, they snake like in that video with their head all hung around. Weird stuff like that. And there is a car that won't stop downshifting in my neighborhood. Sounded good, though. Oh, well, that's a feeding. Yeah, these are just a bunch of ball python feedings. Maybe I'm a gangster too, and it takes two to tango. You don't want to mess with me, mess with me. Maybe I'm a gangster too. Until from like an S curve in their neck, hissing, moving their tail, or even opening their mouth, like this girl. Oh. Yeah, so that's just a mad snake. So usually if you notice I'm S'ing up like that, you notice Bryson right here is very calm. He's roaming around. He could be this close to my face and not really care. I can give him a little kiss, and he does not care. Where this snake in this video is not having it.
I put my ball python in the tub with warm water, and this was his reaction. Wait for it. I put my
Yeah, so I've done this like once to help him shedding, and he didn't react well. He basically flopped around like a fish out of water and then pooped all over the bathtub. The water was at the right temperature. He was fine. It wasn't too deep, but he did not enjoy it. I know other snakes like anacondas and actually boas like to soak and stuff too. Usually if you find these guys soaking in a water dish, it's an issue. You don't want that to happen. But you can commonly find like anacondas, some boas, and some other stuff soaking in water dishes. And usually that's not a bad sign if there are no other suspicions happening. But yeah.
When your ball python decides to take a bite out of you. When your ball python...
Yeah. Look, I've never been bit by Bruce. I'm going to be honest. Only thing I've been bit by was a sand boa at my work. And he wasn't that big. It didn't feel like anything. But, and then, like I told you, that banana lemon blast tries to light me up. But he's missed. He bump struck me one time. And then, he's missed the past couple, so, luckily he hasn't connected with any.
Me falls asleep with my pet ball python out of his cage. I know I left him here. Oh god, I hope he didn't fall off my bed. Oh, I found him. This is Reggie. Me falls asleep.
Don't fall asleep with your snake out.
Not gonna be fun. Oh my god. How do you even... He gets himself into these situations. Alright. I feel like that should be a good cutoff. Yep, we're done. Alright. Say goodbye. And ball python kisses. Peace out, guys. I'll talk to you in another video.